right? So now we have marriage equality. We also have to remember that in Puerto Rico we had a civil code revision that was very close of getting civil unions in 2006, but because of a very corrupt senator that is now in jail, he stopped that revision, but we were at this cusp of receiving civil unions in 2006. So we were very, very close of doing that. And in Puerto Rico last year, we passed four pro-LGBT laws. One of them was the Employment Non-Discrimination Bill, the Domestic Violence Law, including LGBT people, and we passed two laws to include same-sex couples in the protections under the health plans in the public and private sectors. So we've gone a long way, and we've moved, you know, in spite of, as Melissa mentioned, there's a lot of opposition from the fundamentalist sector in Puerto Rico. Last year, we had tens of thousands of people rallying in front of the Capitol, and even in spite of that, the Puerto Rican legislature voted to approve these four bills. So the public pressure was very, very big in terms of trying to stop those bills from becoming law, and we passed those laws. So now we're at the verge of just getting marriage equality. And I want to acknowledge and thank Melissa, because she came to lobby when we were trying to get those bills passed. She flew from New York to be with us here on the eve of the vote that happened in the Senate for those bills. She came to Puerto Rico to lobby, and she directly lobbied a couple of the senators and legislatures there. So we want to thank them. And as well, there were several occasions when Rosie and Danny came to Puerto Rico to also support us in our struggle against the hate crimes. So we did all this work this has been done in spite that all the work that is done in Puerto Rico is done on a volunteer basis. We don't have paid staff in Puerto Rico for LGBT organizations in Puerto Rico. That is done in a volunteer basis. So imagine if we had the capacity of having paid staffers for organizations here in Puerto Rico, which is amazing that we're able to do that. And right now we have been calling, and we call upon the governor once again. We have called upon him because he has done great things and he has approved four laws. But still, on the issue of marriage equality, he's still behind. And I think that he should call and he should follow the example of President Obama and other governors that have ordered their attorney generals from their states and their jurisdictions and the United States of America to not defend what is undefendable. You know, we call upon Governor Garcia Padilla, and we call it once again, that he should stop defending the law that discriminates and excludes LGBT.